Before we discuss the widely used public key algorithms RSA and Diffie-Hellman, let's go over the background first. Both RSA and Diffie-Hellman are based on number theory, an ancient and yet active field in mathematics. These public key algorithms use modular arithmetic, including modular addition, modular multiplication, and modular exponentiation, and they make use of results from number theory. Let's briefly introduce the background of modular arithmetic. First, let's explain modular addition. Given a modulus m, x plus y mod m is the remainder of x plus y divided by m. For example, 2 plus 8 divided by 10, the remainder is 0. So therefore, 2 plus 8 mod 10 is 0, whereas 3 plus 8 mod 10 is 1, because 3 plus 8 is 11, and 11 divided by 10, the remainder is 1. Therefore, 3 plus 8 mod 10 is 1. In modular addition, if we add a number and its inverse, then the result is 0. For example, if the modulus is 10, then for k equal to 2, its inverse is 8, because 2 plus 8 mod 10 is 0. Having additive inverse means that modular addition is reversible. That is, by adding the inverse, we can reverse the result of modular addition. This is very convenient for encryption and decryption, because as we have discussed, we want the encryption process to be reversible, meaning that ideally, the decryption process is just the reverse of the encryption process. For example, given plaintext P equal to 3, suppose the key K is 2, and the way we encrypt the plaintext P is to add the key under modular addition to plaintext P, and the result is ciphertext C. So C equal to P plus K, which is 3 plus 2 mod 10, the result is 5. That is, the ciphertext C of plaintext P equal to 3 is 5. Now, how do we decrypt? To decrypt, we use the same process, but instead of using the key, we use the key's inverse. We know that the inverse of 2 is 8. So therefore, C plus K inverse is 5 plus 8 mod 10. That is 13 mod 10. The result is 3, which is exactly the plaintext. And so this is how we can do decryption, by using the exact same process as the encryption. And instead of using the key, we use its inverse in decryption. And we take advantage of the fact that under modular addition, each number has an inverse. Therefore, each key has an inverse. And we just use the inverse of the key in decryption.